We have a number of public comment speakers. I'm going to call on three at a time. So if you come up CRQ with the name of the first one, unless that's the next one is Craig R, and then one after that is Joanna S. So if there is a CRQ that's different from Craig R, and then first.
There's no CRQ.
Is there a CRQ?
There is not. There is no CRQ.
Great. And next we hear from Mr. Craig R, followed by Joanna S, followed by Adam R. Welcome.
Craig R, also on the Community Action Network. I'd like to say, first of all, we in the organization strongly support Council President Wesson's motion for the anti-convention motion. But with two notes, we'd like to know that it should be amended later to include planter boxes and all these gardens and all these other obstruction devices that business owners are using to displace homeless people off the sidewalk. And secondly, we would like there to be a real enforcement of the fact that these operations and dispensing already violate current law because it is outside of the permitting process that has to go through the city attorney's office. So we would like for LAPD to be instructed to enforce the current law as well as this new law in order to get them to take down these illegal fence structures as well as the later amended parking planter box structure. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I have S, followed by Adam R, followed by General Dyer.
Joanna with the Democratic Socialist of America, Street Walk LA. Just wanted to echo the demand that you actually enforce this motion. The city attorney has already agreed that it's illegal. We see every Tuesday, just a block north of here, people losing their belongings on the sidewalk, getting thrown away by LA Sand. We see that you enforce 5611 and poking all across the city. People lose their tents because they're soiled, or their wheelchairs because they're broken. You know, these are planters, and I'm just going to read you a couple quotes from some documents that came to light recently. You can guess house or unhoused. The situation here is deplorable. It's so frustrating to be left out in the cold like this. It is not fair. We are exhausted. We are frustrated. We feel helpless. This is an email of a property owner conducting a collaborative effort with LA Sand, my common staffers, and LAPD in order to actually do the opposite of enforcement and actually collaborate with the city to displace homeless people in Venice. So, thank you. Please stop the displacement.
Thank you. Adam R, followed by General Goggin, followed by Eddie Beach.
Go!
To continue on Joanna's point, what each of you have in front of you and the back of your packets is evidence of conspiracy to violate the law. That would make it a criminal conspiracy between my client's office, the LAPD, and property owners in these areas. What we have and what we're seeing is a new attempt at the same sort of party that we have in Skid Row. Criminalize those who are homeless. At the same time, wasting money, like the Triple H money, that's supposed to be building housing. Once again, I encourage you to read these emails, look at these photographs, and enforce the law. You are happy to enforce 5611, but let us remind you of 5612, which holds property owners accountable for illegal structures on the streets or in front of their buildings.
Right.
I would love to see a 5612 committee. Because we spent years trying to make 5611 useful to criminalize homeless people instead of the merchants it was originally designed for. Thank you.
I'm here with Ellie Gann, and I'm here to support the motion. I would like to say also that when it comes to a homeless person putting their property on the ground, you got an arsenal of laws to criminalize them. 4118B, sitting here asleep or lying on the sidewalk, 4118A, lowering 4118B, blocking the sidewalk, and like my man said, 5611, storing personal property on the sidewalk. But in the same vein, business put their property on the ground. Not only did they put their property on the ground, but they dig into the concrete. They tap concrete, remove the concrete, it bolt up stuff, steel poles into the ground, right? And the city attorney has already classified, Gavin Flores has already said this is illegal, right? But LAPD refused to enforce because they had a conspiracy with the business improvement district,
right?
The families, the housing association, and everybody else, right? To criminalize them. So we're here today to say that this is long coming. We support the motion. It goes further than what's on the table. And
thank you very much. Eddie H. followed by Steve Dion, followed by Keith Rock.
Eddie H. followed by Senator Community Action Network. Again, you've already heard from the comments that we agree with the motion, but we also agree that it doesn't go far enough. We know in this city that they only have one comprehensive strategy as it relates to homeless individuals, and that's criminalization. And it's been criminalization the first, second, and third. We go all back to the CI in 2006, 2015, when the city spent $1 billion on criminalization. Not one penny into urban supported housing, but even hygiene services. And we're here to say that criminalization is not the answer. Never been the answer. And we want criminalization out of every aspect of housing services. Even with the bridge to home, there's a criminalization around that, which is up to $96,000 a month to have police officers criminalize the area around those places. We say without equivocation, the criminalization is not the answer. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next is Steve Diaz, followed by Chris Rock, followed by Adam Smith.
Good afternoon, committee members. My name is Steve Diaz, and I am a public hand. We're here in support of Councilmember Wesson's motion and also support this committee taking up this crucial issue that's impacting many communities across Los Angeles. We definitely feel that it's important to expand the scope of the motion to ensure that all forms of architecture are being included, especially now with the rapid use of architecture as a method to move people from being able to access public sidewalks. We feel that's imperative to include planters, other forms of architecture that have been used along with fencing, along with any other type of individual that have been reported. Additionally, property owners should be held accountable for this if they're not permitted, and it's upon the city to ensure that the permitting is being held, and if the property owners are not having a proper permit, to ensure that the property owners are being cited and forced to remove. Thank you.
Chris Rock, followed by Adam Smith, and then by the general.
Thank you, committee. My name is Chris Rock, with the Power of LA.
Sorry,
third time. Wow. Thank you. Chris Rock, with PSA Los Angeles, Power of LA, and Korea Tongue Hall. The cropping up of all these planters as well as the fences throughout Korea Town and all over the entire city are endemic and part of the sanitation and LAPD criminalization of homelessness, where they're just moving people from one street to the next and allowing the business owners and the owners of these buildings to set up these obstructions in the public space is simply moving the problem from one neighborhood to the next. This is a very classic example of the NIMBY effect of everyone saying, hey, we really want to make sure that all of these homeless people have shelter, we want them to be safe, we just don't want them to be safe on our streets, and when we see someone else. Shoving them from one street to the next and putting up these fences and flagrants to make sure that they can't come back into the neighborhood is just flat out wrong, and it is also illegal, as pointed out in 5612. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Adam Smith, followed by General Tim.
Good afternoon. Adam Smith, I'm an organizer of White People for Black Lives and a member of the Services on the Streets Coalition. I hope everyone had a chance to look at the packet that we dropped up earlier. And I want to stress that the pictures in this are a fraction of what is going on, what's being installed weekly, it seems like, across the city. Just in Venice, if you're familiar with the area from the beach to Lincoln, in between the beach and Lincoln, and in between Rhodes and Venice, there's about 160 of these planters. And like I said, more are being added every day, every week. And at best, we have city employees from LAP, Pacific Division, Captain Jim Setzer, to Taylor Bashley, and Mike Bond's office. At best, they were confused and thought that facilitating the installation of unpermitted structures across Venice was somehow in their job.
description, which I assume that it's not. So thankful for the council president's motion and support, but hope that there will be amendment to include everything that's going on.
Thank you. And finally, your gentleman.
Afternoon, committee members. My name is General Jeff. I am the chair of the Skidmore Neighborhood Council Formation Committee. Our Formation Committee strongly supports this motion. I authored a city watch piece on this very topic in 2017, so it's been 2 years long overdue. And within that article, we mentioned specifically an area in Skidmore called, where the property owners called it the North Sea. And also in that article, we have coined the hashtag DisplaceGate, because that's exactly what's going on. Also, too, we have video of the collaboration between city employees through Operation Healthy Streets, coordinating through the Bureau of Sanitation, Los Angeles Police Department, coordinating with the fence installing folks to install the fences after the extensive street cleans. We also have allies that have PRAs of city employees that have issued emails of these very exact collaboration efforts. And just so you know, the state of California has been notified, and there's a potential $50,000 fine per parcel where there are concrete cuts because they violated anyone to call 811 and verify that information.
Yes, Mr. Clear. This meeting is adjourned. Thank you.